Now, usually I don't do this, but go ahead on,
you smile every time you hear this song.
Never gets old.
Yeah, it's a good one. Ignition remix. It's so much better than the non remix version.
Night and day.
I actually only heard this song for the first time this year.
But it's that should be a topic. That should be a topic.
All right, good. We're here, episode 3. We're moving right along in this season.
Welcome, guys. Thanks for joining us.
At what point do we switch to season 2? Because we're going to say, like, season 1, episode 1.
We got to go every time we change shirts. Anytime we get into a new outfit, we go new season.
New season. Okay, great. I like that idea. All right, we got a good topic today. We got a question for you, well, a topic for you. It's not really a question. And we got 10 minutes starting right now.
All right.
If you know one thing about me, what's my favorite thing in the world?
Quesaritos from Taco Bell.
Yep. That's it. Yep. Okay. What's my other favorite thing in the world?
You love game shows, Luke.
I do love game shows. Okay. I watch way too many game shows. You know, it's like, it's the easiest thing to watch while you're doing other things.
True.
Because it doesn't matter. And so we have set on our DVR to record every single day, Family Feud.
No.
That's what we've been watching lately. It's so good.
You have season passes for Family Feud and just game shows in general?
Well, no, I mean, we record them, yeah. Family Feud, Wheel of Fortune, and Price is Right.
Okay. No Jeopardy, huh?
I'm not smart enough for Jeopardy. I can't play along. I'm really good at Family Feud these days, though. And then there was a while there, and this was actually when I was on paternity leave, where we watched every episode of Price is Right for like 2 months straight, which is a lot of episodes.
Here's what Price of Right reminds me of. Pretending like I'm sick when I'm at home with my mom and dad in elementary school or junior high or whatever.
Yep.
And watching like Bob Barker and Price is Right. And not even, I think he was so old that I thought at the time that they were like old shows replaying in the morning. I didn't realize they were like new live shows.
Recording new ones.
Yeah. Right. That's what I think of when I think of Price is Right. Yeah, now it's my dude Drew Carey, right?
Skinny Drew Carey. Skinny Drew Carey is not as funny as fat Drew Carey.
Yeah, turns out you lose funniness with those pounds. Yep. But good on you, Drew. I'm proud of you.
I am too.
Way to keep it off.
So we watch Price is Right. When you watch Price is Right that much, you start to... You start to notice patterns in the game, and I actually think I'd be really good at going on Price is Right now. Like,
you should try.
I don't even know how. I should try. Okay, that's what I'm gonna do. And you know, you start to learn like the models' names, and you're like, oh no,
that's too much fandom.
Did you know that they have a male model now on Price is Right?
I did not. I couldn't even tell you the last time I saw Price is Right.
His name is James.
James.
Yeah. All right. And so anyway, so we watch Price is Right a lot. You start to learn some of the tips and tricks on like how to beat different games and just like what the format of the show is, because they actually have at each like game stage, like each prize is within some price range. So that can already, like, just knowing that can help you narrow your guess a little bit.
Yeah, that's a huge advantage. You should write a book.
I should. How to Beat Price is Right. Signed, the person that's never been on the show.
I've never been on, but I've watched a lot of it.
I watched it a lot on paternity leave. Okay, so one of the things that I was curious about is, you know, you go on Price is Right and you, you know, you get into the game, and whether or not you win your game, you get to go to the showcase showdown.
Okay.
Right, at the end, where they have two contestants, they show them a bunch of prizes, It's usually like a car and a trip and some luggage or a boat. Luggage.
And like a jacuzzi or something.
And a jacuzzi, right, exactly. Or a new kitchen. And then they bid on them or they say how much they think it costs, and then the closest one wins and gets theirs. Right. So that's how that works. And so then I was wondering, okay, what happens to these people after they win? If they win a bunch of stuff, what happens to them? Like, do they walk home with these prizes? Like, do they drive that car home today? Like, what actually happens? Do you have any thoughts or guesses? I looked it up, and I know.
That's the question for me.
Yeah.
What happens when they win the Price is Right?
Yeah.
I just want to actually showcase.
What's that?
Okay, go on. Go on. Go on.
Just, it doesn't have to specifically be the Price is Right, because I researched other game shows because I love this. And like Family Feud, if you win Family Feud, you get $20,000 and you get to come back the next day and you can come back up to 5 days, which means you can get $100,000. And okay. If you win 5 times in a row, you also get a car.
Okay.
You know, and so you like, you kind of learn like how the show works over multiple days and not just like one at a time, like a normal person would watching the show every once in a while. But okay. All of them work the same. I'm like, after the show ends, what happens? Do you hand me that money in cash or what?
Yeah. So, okay. So I win, let's just stick with Price is Right for now. I win a trip to the Bahamas. I win a brand new Chevy Cruze or whatever terrible mid-sized car they're giving away that day. And like a brand new kitchen for my...
They're always terrible cars, by the way.
Oh, they're the worst cars, dude.
Yeah.
I saw one time somebody win like a Chevy Cavalier. I was like, wait, what? Do they say you're sorry when they give you the keys? Yeah. I'm sorry, but...
It's funny because sometimes they'll do the... Because mostly for the car games, you win it by guessing how much it costs.
Okay.
And someone was like, they're like $15,000 cars.
Like, right.
What? I didn't even know they made $15,000 cars.
No, fair point, right? Or at least not new ones.
No.
Yeah, so I think... And I'm going to just like kind of walk you through my thought process here. Because I obviously don't know how it works. But I would imagine... based on our lotto conversation from a couple of episodes ago and kind of understanding how that works, that you don't get everything up front, right? So you take like a stipend every year for however many years, or if you decide, hey, I want like the cash value of these prizes, it's like dramatically reduced, right? So say my showcase was worth like 40 grand. If I'm like, oh yeah, I just want that money right now, they're like, okay, here's like 7 grand. Thanks for coming on the show, right? And that, I don't know, like maybe they just cut you a check, maybe a giant check, like a Happy Gilmore golf check that you throw in the back of your Chevy Cavalier and you drive off into the sunset. But say like you want like the actual prizes, I'm going to say for your trip you get like some terrible voucher that you can only use on like Tuesdays and Thursdays of October of odd numbered years or something crazy like that. And, I don't know, like, so I win a brand new jacuzzi. Do they, like, come put it in my house, or do I get, like, a gift card to jacuzzis.com, or?
Yeah.
No, that's a good question. I'm, like, I'm really intrigued right now by this topic because.
Okay.
I'm going to read your book, and then I'm going to go on The Price is Right, and I'm going to win a bunch of.
I'll sign it for you. You can come to the author signing. Okay, so here's my understanding of how this works based on all the research that I've done. Price is Right is interesting because Price is Right, the way that they make money is it's not just the commercials that they air, but like the prices themselves are ads, right? They're saying, hey, look, here's a beautiful Chevy Malibu and this is how much it costs. It's actually cheaper than you probably thought, right?
And Chevy paid them for that.
And so the Price is Right actually says, you know what? The point of the show is to not win value, not to win money. The point of the show is for us to give away prizes.
Okay.
And so if you don't want that prize, you can't get cash value for it.
Oh, okay.
You take the prize or you don't take the prize. By the way, you have to front the taxes for the prize.
Okay. Okay. I figured that because when you play the slot machines for the cars in Vegas or whatever, you have to pay the tax if you win the car, right? So that makes sense to me. But you got paid up front. Otherwise, I don't take it.
Yeah. And you, right. And And you don't have to decide immediately because you're not going to get that car that day anyway. They give you a voucher, even for a car. They give you a voucher to go to the Chevy dealership, wherever it is that you live, and they'll trade it in for a car. But in order to get the voucher, you have to pay the money.
Okay, gotcha.
That makes sense?
Yeah.
So,
and then when I get to the dealership, they try and upsell me? Or are they just like, here's your base model 2012?
That's interesting. I have no idea. Yeah. They'd be dumb not to, right?
Yeah.
So that's for like a car, right? So let's say...
So now I want a trip to the Bahamas. Like, tell me what happens.
A trip to the Bahamas?
Yeah.
It's actually about the same. It works about the same. They give you... It's usually scheduled for a specific day. And if you can't make it that day, then don't pay for it. Like, don't pay the taxes on it.
Out of luck. Got it.
It's like, here it is. The trips always fly out of L.A. So if you're not from L.A., you got to figure out how to get to L.A. that day for the flight.
Okay.
None of that's exchangeable.
I'm never going on The Price is Right. The show sucks now.
Right. Yeah, that's basically what ends up. Oh, time's up.
Boo, Price is Right.
Okay, time out. Wait, can I just finish this real quick? Okay. So one of the differences, so one thing that changes is, so let's say Wheel of Fortune. Wheel of Fortune, you're more likely to win cash and prizes, right? Because you can win a trip from Wheel of Fortune, and you can also win cash. The one thing that is kind of cool about that is that the cash that you win is real cash and can go towards paying the taxes for your trip.
Oh, that is interesting.
And so if you win a trip to the Bahamas and you win $12,000, they'll ask you, hey,
do you want to use your winnings?
Right. You can take $4,000 in the trip, or you can take the $12,000.
Okay. No, that is interesting. So I'm going to go on Wheel of Fortune. It's way better.
Right, because you get cash with it too. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. The other thing that's interesting about it is, so these prizes that you win, even if you do have to front the cash for taxes, it's still less than what the item's worth, right? So let's say you win a pool table from The Price is Right. The taxes that you're going to pay is less than what the pool table's worth. So if you want, you could pay the taxes, get the item, which, by the way, doesn't happen same day. They'll send it to you months and months later.
Oh, no.
And then you can sell it like brand new on Craigslist or whatever you want, right? And hope that you win more money. But what people have complained about is that a lot of these items come as like Price is Right branded and nobody wants to buy them. And so they sell for like so little under market value, right? Or like MSRP
for Crazy. A
pool table. And so people end up losing money and have thought like, oh yeah, I'll just pay the taxes, get that, and I'll resell it. And then they end up losing money on the whole thing.
This has been a very informative episode.
Yeah.
I learned a lot tonight.
Good. Sometimes people will learn stuff, sometimes they won't.
We don't guarantee anything that we said tonight is factual, just disclaimer, but I learned a lot tonight.
Oh, yeah, no, it's probably mostly, I mean, this was just from like some random post that I read online like 5 months ago, so I don't actually remember if I remember that correctly, but
I like it.
Close enough.
Bible to me.
It sounds accurate.
I love it.